was fortunate for Mary Carter that she was home on that certain spring evening a few weeks after she celebrated her 21st birthday. Otherwise, she might have missed that eagerly awaited first opportunity to vote. What happened was that Mr. Calhoun came to call. Mr. Calhoun was leader of his political party in the precinct, or section of the town, where Mary lived. He had come to urge Mary's parents to vote in the primary election next month. Mary's parents weren't home, but she was curious about an election next month. She thought it was not till November. Mr. Calhoun explained that the general election would be held in November, but that first came the primary election. Mary had not yet registered as a voter, so Mr. Calhoun urged her to do so right away because it was her duty as a citizen to vote in the primary and in all elections. The next morning, Mary went to the registration place. There is usually one for every 200 or 300 voters. The purpose of registration is to make sure that only those people vote who are legally entitled to vote. So Mary had to prove that she was a citizen of the United States and over the age of 21. Her evidence of this was her birth certificate. She had to meet other voting requirements, too. She had to be a legal resident of her state. In some states, she would have to show that she could read and write, and in others that she had paid a poll tax. Then she was called upon to swear to the truth of her statements. She signed the registration cards with the same signature she would use later when voting. Other states use a registration book for this purpose. Mary had now completed her registration. She was entitled to vote in the coming primary election to choose the candidates who would run later in the general election. On the way home, Mary noticed that several candidates from the same party were trying for nomination to the same office. This meant that she'd not only have to decide what party to vote for, but that she'd have to find out about the individual candidates. The newspapers were a big help. To obtain a complete picture, Mary consulted newspapers of different political opinions. She read up on the candidates from their own advertisements and from the political columns. Here, too, she found a complete list of candidates running in the primary. These men were named on the ballot because each had presented a petition signed by a certain number of voters. The newspaper also printed a sample ballot from which Mary learned the form of the ballots to be used in the election. She discussed the election and the various candidates with her parents and friends. She collected and studied the handbills and pamphlets put out by various nonpartisan groups and by the candidates themselves, telling of their qualifications for office. Deciding how to vote was a serious problem, so Mary made up a checklist. Facts to know about each candidate. What is his experience? What are his views on important issues? What about his character? How effectively can he represent the issues for which he stands? If he has held office before, did he do a good job? On this basis, Mary considered each candidate and selected the men and the party that she would support in the primary election. Primary day was an exciting day for Mary. Near the voting place, but not within 100 feet, party workers were passing out sample ballots and handbills, urging her to vote for their candidates. Mary voted at the same place she had registered. Voting is such an important affair that there is quite a bit of formality connected with it. Election judges and clerks are in charge of the polling places to see that all voting is properly done. Once again, Mary signed her name on a card. This card was checked against the registration records to be sure she was qualified to vote. Mary was registered, so she went along to the election judge. The judge gave her 2 ballots, one for each political party that was electing nominees. In some states, she would be given only the ballot of the party she was supporting. But in this open primary, she was given both of them to make her choice of party and individual candidates in the privacy of the voting booth. Meanwhile, party watchers are observing the election to report any irregularities. Policemen watch for any violations of the election laws. And the election officials, of course, are in charge. In the voting booth, Mary marked the ballot of the party she was supporting. She discarded the ballot of the other party, while an official made sure it was a legal ballot that she put in the box. So Mary had voted for the first time as a citizen of the United States. When all the votes were counted, the candidate with the most votes was declared the party nominee for each office. In most states, a plurality is sufficient for nomination. Now, the nominees put on intensive campaigns to win votes in the forthcoming general election. Again, the matter of selecting the best man for each office was a vital concern to Mary. Although in the primary, she had declared herself for one party, she was not bound to vote for its candidate in the general election. So she looked into the background of the candidates of all parties and learned their views on important issues. She listened to as many of their speeches as she could. She discussed their relative merits with her friends and her family. She gathered all the information she could to help her select the men best qualified to manage her government. By the day of the general election, Mary had informed herself about all the candidates and was ready to mark her ballot. Now, how Mary voted is her own private business. Her state allowed her, if she chose, to vote for all the candidates from one party by putting an X in the box at the top of the party list. But many states have stopped this because well-informed voters usually prefer to vote for the man they consider best, regardless of party. This is generally known as the Australian ballot, because this method of secret voting originated in Australia in the early 19th century, becoming common in the United States in the 1890s. When voting hours are over, the voting place is closed and the election officials prepare to count the votes. Generally speaking, only the election officials and party watchers are allowed to be present when the votes are counted. In some communities, impartial watchers are appointed by the courts. The boxes are unlocked, and the ballots are taken out and counted orally. Election officials are the only ones permitted to handle the ballots. The election clerks mark the count on their official tally sheets. Some ballots are marked for straight party tickets. Others are marked for individual candidates. A ballot should be marked carefully. For example, if one is marked both ways, it may be discarded in many states. If an X is marked outside a box, election officials in some states may invalidate the ballots. In some places, a ballot may be discarded also if two candidates are marked for the same office. Usually, very few ballots have to be discarded because of improper marking. When all the ballots are tallied, the votes are totaled. Then, the ballots are put back in the boxes, locked and sealed, and sent to a place of safekeeping where they'll be kept until it is certain that there is no question about the legality of the election. The tally sheets are sent to the city or county election headquarters. There, they are added to the returns from all the other local polling places. These figures are then sent to state election officials who make the final count and declare the candidates with the highest number of votes winners in the election. On the morning after the election, Mary was eager to learn the outcome. She was glad and proud to learn that most of the candidates she had supported won. She was also proud to have fulfilled her first obligation as a citizen. Looking back, We don't know how Mary voted, but we know that she did vote. What's more, we know that she informed herself about the various candidates so that she could vote intelligently. And so she has made her contribution toward keeping democracy alive.